Hey, my name's Dan, and this video is going to be an introduction to using breakpoints in Framer. We're going to cover all the ways you can make your design adapt to multiple screen sizes. So let's just jump right in. If we hop over to Framer, we can see this hero section I've put together. It's pretty simple. There's a nav, there's some H1, H3 text, there's some CTAs, and then there's this logo wall. If we preview this, we can see that we've got some work to do to make it responsive. So the first thing we need to do is come back and set some breakpoints. You can set breakpoints by clicking this plus button up here. I'm going to add a tablet and I'm going to add a phone. Now you can customize the breakpoint sizes if you double click on the top bar, but we're going to keep Framer's defaults for now because they're pretty good. Now, if this is your first time using Framer's breakpoints, something to point out is that all these elements are linked across different breakpoints. So what do I mean by that? If I click on this H1 and I go ahead and make it absolute, you can see that that change happened on all of the breakpoints. And that's because I copied those other breakpoints from the desktop breakpoint, and they're all linked. Now, if I go into the phone breakpoint and I override that change, you can see how it doesn't apply backup. The changes only flow one direction. This is really helpful if you need to make a lot of changes because it means you don't have to do them on multiple breakpoints. You can just do them on the desktop one and they'll roll out to all the others. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is change this H1 text so that it's the right size on all of these different breakpoints. Now, there's a couple of ways I could do this. The easiest way is to just select the text and go down here and change the font size. But that's pretty tedious, and if we're going to use this H1 text again, we're going to have to make all those changes again. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to make a textile. So if I select the desktop H1 and go down to styles, you'll see that Framer has a bunch of textiles set up for us. If we go in here, you can see that it's all enter, but we want to make a new one. So I'm going to hit new style and I'm going to call it H1. And you can see my lovely blue text disappeared. So let's just add that back quickly. And now if we scroll over to the other breakpoints, you can see that the text size has changed. And that's because text styles have breakpoints. So if we go in here, we can see that there's large, medium, and small. And it has automatically made sure that the smaller breakpoints have smaller font sizes. But of course, we can come in and tweak the value. So I'm going to make that 40 on the phone. I'm going to make it about 52 on the tablet. And I'm going to leave the large one, obviously, where it is. Okay, so next up, we want to make sure that this text doesn't run into the sides of the container. So what I'm going to do is make sure I select the desktop version. And I'm going to add a max width. I'm going to make the max width the current size. So I'm going to select fixed. I'm going to make it 895. And then I'm going to make it fill. And I'm going to do the same for this text down here. So if I add max width, change it to fixed, select 588, copy it here, and change that to fill. Now we can see that the text is wrapping on the smaller screens, but it's still butting up against the sides. So I'm going to add some padding, and I'm going to add some padding to the logo wall too. But of course, I'm going to do this on the desktop so that those changes roll downhill. So I'm going to make this 24 and 24. It looks great. I might want to make it a little bit smaller on phone. So I'm going to make it 16. So that's looking good so far, but we still need to fix this logo wall. So if I select this, I can see that the text is set to fixed, so we need to change that on the desktop. Make that fill, it's fine. I'm going to make sure that this container is set to fill. So now we've got the text to wrap, and if we want the logos to wrap, we need to hit wrap down here. Now that's a little bit weird, but if we make the container fill, we should get two rows. Perfect. So let's preview what we've done so far. It's largely looking pretty good. But the last thing we need to tackle is this nav component. So let's go do that. Now, because the nav bar is a component, it isn't as simple as changing the layout for this breakpoint. Anytime we need a component to have a different layout for a breakpoint, we have to make a new variant. So let's go ahead and do that. We make a new variant of this and we call it tablet. And we rename the primary variant to desktop. I'm going to go ahead and change the width of the tablet variant to be 810 10. This is the smallest our tablet size can be, so that's why I'm doing that. If I go in here, see, that's largely okay, so we don't really need to do anything, but we will need to do something for the phone. I'm going to rename this, and I'm going to change its width to be about 390, which is a good size for a phone. And you can see it's completely broken. Now, this is going to be a little bit tricky because we want to use something like a hamburger menu, but we need to rework the structure of this component to make that work. Framer has a handy hamburger menu icon component, so I'm going to drag that in. If we go down to patterns and scroll down, here it is. All this is an icon that changes from burger to X. But before we do anything with that, we're going to need two variants of the phone component. We're going to need a collapsed and expanded state. So let's rename this to phone collapsed, and let's add another variant called expanded. Okay, so now I'm going to add the hamburger icon into this component. I'm going to turn off the links and buttons. We set this to space between. Okay, so now that the collapsed state is looking how we want, let's work on the expanded state. Okay, so now that that's all set up, all we need to do is add a transition between the two. So I'm going to click on interactions up here, and I'm going to change so that when we tap on this, it's going to go to the expanded state. And likewise, when we tap on this, it's going to go to the collapsed state. Now, if we go back and preview this, we'll see that nothing's happening. And that's because we need to change out the variant. So on tablet, select tablet. And then on phone, we're going to select phone collapsed. And now if we preview this, it switches between the different components quite nicely. But you might notice that if you click this, the hero text moves. So we need to go back and set this to position fixed, which will dock it right at the top. And we also want to set the width to be 100%. Now, if we preview that, that looks great. We might want to add a shadow behind there, but you get the point. So that's pretty much it for this video. I find a lot of people learning Framer don't know the two things we just discussed, that textiles have different breakpoints, and that you should create variants of your components for different breakpoints if the layout needs to change a lot. If you found this video helpful, I have a few other beginner Framer videos that discuss things like motion and layout, so you should check those out. I'm also working on an advanced Framer course, and there should be a link to sign up for that in the video description. Anyway, catch you next time.